So, hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I wanted to show you how to make a really easy mug rug using your scrap fabrics. I made some of these for gifts for people and they whipped up so quickly and they bit into a little bit of my scrap pile. Not as much as I would hope, but it means that I have lots more scraps left over and I can make a bunch more, maybe some for me. Actually, I did make one for me, but it's not quite finished yet. So this is what it looks like. So it's just strip piecing, but it's quilt as you go. And as I said, I'm using up scrap fabrics. So when I have this finished, it still needs to be bound. When I have it finished, it's gonna be just for me though. So I'm gonna put that aside right now and I'll show you how to do this. I just took some scrap fabric for the back. Actually, this is, I think, curtain kind of fabric from IKEA. So I have that, and then I just decided what size I wanted it and cut it that size. So you can do the same thing, it doesn't have to be very big. And then I cut batting, and I cut the batting so that it is a quarter inch smaller all the way around, smaller than the backing fabric. I don't need it to be right out to the edges, that just causes a bit of bulk in the seam. So I cut it a little bit smaller, and then of course I centered it in the middle. So I need to show you how you're gonna lay these strips down because you want them to look the same going across. You don't want, this is not a crazy quilt, so you don't want them all different angles. You want to keep the same angle. So I just took one of my small rulers and I wanted to draw a 45 degree line on the batting. So make sure you've got a pen, a marker of some kind. You're not going to see it later on, so if it doesn't come off, not a big deal. But I used a water erasable marker and just something that is a color that you'll see up against the batting. So white, not so good. Pick a color, blue is good. And I've taken the 45 degree angle on the ruler, lined it up against the bottom of the batting, and then I just make a line across. Doesn't have to be real dark, just enough so you can see it to line up that first piece of fabric. Okay, so you can see I've got that on there. So I want to start with the corner fabric. So this fabric you're going to have facing up. Now I'm using a batik, so it really is hard to tell which is a good thing. And I'm just going to lay it across. You want to make sure any of the fabric strips that you use will extend off the edges of the background fabric. That's very important. Otherwise, you're going to be short and you're going to end up seeing batting and backing. You don't want that. So that looks good. And I take my next piece. So I've got a strip here and I want to put this with the right side, the pretty side down, and I want to line up the edges here. Your fabric doesn't have to be rectangles or squares or anything like that. It does have to have one straight edge to line up when you go to sew. So now that's all ready to go. And because I'm going to see my stitching on the back, I chose a King Tut, I think it's called Cleopatra, this one. It's a 30 weight cotton thread. I want to see some pretty colors on the back. So this is a variegated thread that'll show up and look nice. So I'm just going to start stitching here with a quarter inch seam. You don't need to lock off your stitches because you're going to be, you'll have them, I should say, caught in the binding. So just put my needle down to start and here we go. So I just need to make sure I stitch off the background here. So now I have all this extra fabric that I may or may not want. Okay, we can trim this off at the end, so I don't need to worry about it right now. What I do want to make sure is that the fabric I have here is, for one thing, off the edges, that's covered right across the background fabric, and I want to make sure that it's the width I want. If I don't like this, if this is too wide, for example, I can always take it to my cutting table, make sure you get all the other fabric that was there and the backing and batting out of the way, take it to your cutting table and just trim it down. Remember, we want that straight edge again. Okay, I'm going to keep this one because I like this, but I want to press this over. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take the wooden iron here and just to keep it flat there before we go to our next piece. If you have an iron, you can certainly take it to your ironing board, but for demonstration purposes, I'm just doing it here and it works fine too. So next fabric, again, another batik. So I can just take a look and see what I think looks like the right side. Doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna put the right side down. Again, I'm lining up with the edge of the previous piece I just stitched, and I wanna make sure it's extending off the backing again. Looks good, so let's put that one down. Okay, so that one is also going to be pressed over, and you can see that it extends off the edge. So we don't have an issue there. Now, it's starting to get a little close here though. Okay, so I'm having a little bit of issue there. So what I can do is I'll just trim this down a little bit to where it's actually covering right off the edge there. And if there's a problem with that, you can always stitch an extra piece of fabric on. So that's, it's not a make or break situation. You could always just stitch another piece of fabric, just add a little bit onto the end there, and that will work out just fine as well. So this one, I'm just going to put them over for a little bit and see what it would look like. And then before we go any further, I just want to flip over so you can see what's going on the back side here. So you can see you've got the different stitches that are showing up, different color I should say, and the threads showing up in the stitches on the back. So that's gonna look kind of pretty as well. So if I want to cut this one down a little bit more, I can either take my rotary cutter or I can just take my scissors and cut it down. So I want to make sure that the other fabrics and the batting and backing are out of the way, and I'll just cut this up like this. Trying to keep a straight edge there. Okay, so there we go. So that looks a little bit better. Okay, next one, again, line up those raw edges, make sure they're straight along. Now this has a really straight edge. You can see I didn't quite cut very straight, but that's okay because this one I know is straight. Make sure we extend off the edge there, right side down again, and another quarter inch seam being stitched down. All right. Okay, so I've got some extra fabric here. It's getting a little long, this one, so I'm going to cut it off, making sure I leave some excess there, but let's just cut those extra pieces off on this one so it doesn't quite get in the way for me. All right, that's looking kind of nice so far. So far, so good. Another piece, right side down, making sure it extends on both sides. When you have a long piece like that, you know, it might be tempting to go, oh, I want to save some fabric, let's move it along. But don't do that. Make sure you've got lots of excess on either side. You'd be surprised at, you know, when you turn this over, how much you need to cover, right? So you want to make sure you've got lots there and you don't run yourself short. Although, as I said, you can add some extra fabric. Now, every so often as I go along, I might be starting to get a little off track there. So let's just check with my 45 degree line. Where's my 45 degree line? There it is, there. Okay, so I can just see I can run any of my lines along here, so it's not looking too bad actually. Okay. So we will now stitch this one down. I'm using my Janome 8900 to make this mug rug, and what I really like on it when I'm doing this kind of a project is how I can snip my upper and lower threads with the push of a button. That's what you see me doing at the end all the time, and it doesn't cause any issues when I start all over again, so I don't have to waste time cutting threads or anything. So I really like that about this machine. Okay, so I've got a couple of pieces left here. Let's see. When you come up to the edge here, the last piece on the little corner, you don't want to have an itsy bitsy tiny piece there because it's going to get lost in the binding. Don't forget we're going to be a quarter inch in all over the place. So you want to make sure that you've got a good sized piece there. So I'm going to use this one as my last piece here. Isn't it gorgeous? Well, not really right now, but what I'm going to do is I will take it to my cutting board and I'm going to trim all this off so then you can see what it looks like. So here's the mug rug after it's been all trimmed, so you can see how nice it looks. It's a bit of an improvement from all those pieces of fabric hanging off the edge. So the only thing left to do on this one is to put a binding on it. So just do your regular binding method that you would do and that would be all finished. So I've got that one now and the one I had made for myself, both needing to be bound. But this is just no thinking sewing. So when you have some extra time and you've got fabric scraps that are piling up, this is a good project. You can make some of these, have them in reserve in case you need a gift for someone. And the one that I did For me, the first one just has plain fabric on the back, so you really don't see the stitching. This one, I've added the variegated thread, so you can see what the stitching looks like there. It's kind of pretty. If you want, you can add extra embellishments such as crystals to it, or some hand embroidery, or even applique on it if you wanted to. You can do whatever you want with them. But anytime you just want to do some sewing and don't have to think about it, this is a perfect project to do.